They say that the Japanese lack originality. That they are no more than clever copyists. That they have only ever been interested in profit.
So how do you explain this? The Kawasaki Z1, the biggest and baddest superbike of the 70s.
In 69, Honda had unleashed the CB750, but unlike the lean and mean Z1, the CB was squat and stumpy. Both were biking superstars, but the Z1 was Warren Beatty, the CB750, Ned Beatty.
This is a heavy metal mother of a motorcycle with a storming engine and more style than a Jimmy Page guitar solo. But perhaps more importantly, it's got chrome. And as every biker knew, the more chrome you had, the faster you went. And on that front, Kawasaki made certain no one was going to be in any doubt that this was the fastest production bike in the world.
Should you still be in any doubt as to the cataclysmic impact of this motorcycle? Let me put things in perspective. This is a 1975 Norton Commando 850, the best that Britain could boast, and it never stood a chance. It was giving away two cylinders, 25 horsepower, 15 miles an hour, and around 30 years of development to the Kawasaki. But hey, it had electric start.
Except that the electric start didn't, wasn't up to the job. And the sound of a Commando being kick-started is the sound of the final nail being hammered into the coffin of the British bike industry.
Big Zs were always horny bikes, but the one that had grown men dribbling into the turnips of their Oxford bags back in 78 was the Turbo. It had a paint job ripped off from one of my old tank tops, but more significantly, it had a dirty grape blower, boosting the output of that engine from 80-odd to well over 140 horsepower, but only if you were completely insane. They made fewer than 300 and sold them all in America, which is a good thing, because although it had double discs up front, stopping the thing was like trying to swat an elephant with two rolled-up newspapers. Today, they fetch up to $8,000, but here's a tip. Don't ride it in the rain. But their original affordability meant that most Zs were bought by young men who should have known better, but honestly couldn't be bothered. In those wild and crazy times, many fell by the wayside. Now, they're being resurrected by a bloke in Lancashire and sold on for big bucks. But who's buying?
Mainly wealthy Japanese businessmen and collectors in Japan as well. There's been an awful lot of interest just recently in the last couple of years due to the fact that previously they were only allowed bikes up to 750cc, a bit of a gentleman's agreement in Japan. Consequently, all the big bikes over 750cc, including the 900s and 1000s, went mainly to America and to Europe. What's happening now is the Japanese are allowed to buy back their own machines and they can't get enough of them, so I'm building them.
What makes the Z such a classic?
It's debatable, but I would say it was the first of the superbikes. I mean, there was nothing new about it, if you look at it. We'd had double overhead cam before, we'd had disc brakes before, but we'd never had the complete package at an affordable price that your average man in the street could just go and buy from the showroom and have the fastest production bike in the world. It was the ultimate bike, really.
As I'm concerned, if some noodle magnet from Nagasaki wants an old Z1 to use as a paperweight, then that's just fine by me, as long as they keep sending us these. This is the Kawasaki ZRX1100, a right chip off the old block. And that block is the 100 horsepower lump lifted from the world's second fastest superbike and retuned for more bottom end grunt. Plush suspension and six piston brakes keep things relatively sane. But for £7,249, this is one hell of a lot of motorcycle.
The ZRX is the Burt Reynolds of biking. It's big, it's butch, and it's hopelessly unfashionable. But maybe that's why I like it so much. Most of the time, it's as easy and exciting to ride as a Blackpool tram. But should you, in a moment of madness, crack the throttle and send the rev needle roaring round to the red bit, then it turns into the Tokyo bullet train. Oh yes, the Kawasaki ZRX is entirely capable of behaving very badly.